In Genesis, Jesus Christ is the seed of the woman. In Exodus, he is the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, he is our high priest. In Numbers, he is a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. In Deuteronomy, he is a prophet like unto Moses. In Joshua, he is the captain of our salvation. In Judges, he is your judge and lawgiver. In Ruth, he is your kinsman redeemer. In 1 Samuel, he is your trusted prophet. In Kings and Chronicles, he's your reigning king. In Ezra and Nehemiah, he's the rebuilder of broken down walls of human life. In Esther, he is our Mordecai. In Job, he is our ever-living redeemer. In Psalms, he's our shepherd. In Proverbs and Ecclesiastes, he is our wisdom. In Song of Solomon, he's the loving bridegroom. In Isaiah, he is the Prince of Peace. In Jeremiah, he is the righteous branch. In Lamentations, he is the weeping prophet. In Ezekiel, he is the wonderful four-faced man. In Daniel, he is the fourth man in life's fiery furnace. In Hosea, he is the faithful husband forever married to the backslider. In Joel, he is the baptizer of the Holy Ghost and fire. In Amos, he is our burden bearer. In Obadiah, he is my save. In Jonah, he is a great foreign missionary. In Micah, he is the messenger of beautiful feet. In Nahum, he is the avenger of God's elect. In Habakkuk, he is God's evangelist crying, "Revive thy work in the midst of the years." In Zephaniah, he is our Savior. In Haggai, he is a restorer of God's lost heritage. In Zechariah, he is the fountain opened up in the house of David for sin and uncleanliness. In Malachi, he is the Son of Righteousness, rising with healing in his wings. In Matthew, he is King of the Jews. In Mark, he is the servant. In Luke, he is the Son of Man, feeling what you feel. In John, he is the Son of God. In Acts, he is the Savior of the world. In Romans, he is the righteousness of God. In 1 Corinthians, he is the rock that followed Israel. In 2 Corinthians, he is the triumphant one, giving victory. In Galatians, he is your liberty, he sets you free. In Ephesians, he is head of the church. In Philippians, he is your joy. In Colossians, he is your completeness. In 1 Thessalonians, he is hope. In 1 Timothy, he is faith. In 2 Timothy, he is your stability. In Titus, he is truth. In Philemon, he is your benefactor. In Hebrews, he is your perfection. In James, he is the power behind your faith. In 1 Peter, he is your example. In 2 Peter, he is your purity. In 1 John, he is your life. In 2 John, he is your pattern. In 3 John, he is your motivation. In Jude, he is the foundation of your faith. In Revelation, he is your coming king. He is the first and the last, the beginning and the end. He is the keeper of creation and the creator of all. He always was, he always is, he always will be. Unmoved, unchanged, undefeated, and never undone. He was bruised and brought healing. He was pierced and he's pain. He was persecuted and brought freedom. He was dead and brought life. He is risen and brings power. He reigns and brings peace. The world can't understand him. The armies can't defeat him. Schools can't explain him, and the leaders can't ignore him. Herod couldn't kill him. The Pharisees couldn't confuse him. The people couldn't hold him. Nero couldn't crush him. Hitler couldn't silence him. The New Age can't replace him. And Oprah can't explain him away. He is light, love, longevity, and Lord. He is goodness, kindness, gentleness, and God. He is holy, righteous, mighty, powerful, and pure. His ways are right. His word is eternal. His will is unchanging, and his mind is on me. He is my Savior. He is my Redeemer. He is my guide. He is my peace. He is my joy. He is my comfort. He is my Lord, and he rules my life.